Hey everyone, this is Jess, aka TokuKid. We're here at Japan World Heroes, and I'm here with a very special guest, one of my favorite Kamen Riders of all time, Stephen Ford, aka Kamen Rider Dragonite.
It is, but my name is Stephen, so
I'm so sorry.
No, that's fine. Keep that in.
Okay,
keep that in.
Keep
that's
that
great.
In. Let's run with that.
That's
right.
Amazing. That's some real stuff.
All right, hi. Hi. So, one thing you want to know is you're like the second attempt at Kamen Rider in America.
Yes.
Dragonite back in 2009, if I remember correctly.
Correct.
So, how was your experience during that time filming?
It was the best, one of the greatest experiences I've ever had on a set. You know, it was one of those situations where the only stuff that I had done before then was like a bunch of Disney Channel stuff, a bunch of Nickelodeon stuff, like a lot of like really, really kid stuff. And what's interesting is, like, the show, it's easy to say, oh, it was just, like, a kid's show, right?
Yeah, yeah.
But it had some genuinely dark elements to it.
You had writers who died.
Who died. Yeah. Like, actually, like, there were genuine emotional stakes. And it was something that they hadn't really done with a series like that over here. Yeah. And so Steve and Mike Wang, they wanted to do something genuinely different. And I'm just extremely lucky that I got to be a part of it. And, it was one of the greatest experiences ever.
Now, with that, I remember seeing a set photo of you in the actual Dragonite suit. Did you do any of the stunts in suit?
So I didn't do actually any of the stunts.
Okay.
They wouldn't let me. They were like, okay, it's a liability. You're going to die. Don't do any stunts. And I'm like, I can do it. They didn't like that. Now, Matt Mullins, he did his own stunts because he's an amazing martial artist.
If I remember correctly, a lot of the writers in your show were stunt people, weren't they?
Yes, they were. They were. And even if they weren't stunt people, they had martial arts background. Mm-hmm. You have people like Mike Moe that like really knew what they were doing when it comes to a lot of these things. And I'm coming in there like 17, 18 years old being like, hey guys, what's up? I know I can throw a punch too. And like in reality, no, I could not. So they were probably right to not let me do a lot of stunts.
Okay.
But I think I got to kick like one guy.
Right,
but the set photo of me like in the Kamen Rider outfit, I literally wore it for like 5 hours. Like I wore it for no time. I tried to get them to let me, and they're like, "You're gonna break it, Steven. You're gonna break."
I have a question for that.
The costume.
Was that suit made for you, or were you wearing the stunt guy suit?
I was wearing the. They made it for somebody else.
Okay.
What's interesting though is I didn't fit it, so. Even though I was like, back then I was like 120 pounds. I was like skinny, but I was like too tall for the suit. So I was like, it was like, hey, what's up, guys? How you doing? And it didn't work out. But yeah, man, it was, I wish that they had let me do that. It's just they didn't.
Okay.
You know how it is.
Yeah.
Yeah.
But with that, have you seen any of your Japanese counterpart, Kamen Rider Ryuki?
So the first thing that I did when I got cast, because I had no idea what this show was at all. When I got cast, they were like, yo, this is a really big deal. And I'm like, okay, it's based off of something. I really want to watch the thing that it's based off of. How do I go about doing that? And I asked the Wangs. I was like, yo, can I borrow the show? And they're like, we don't have this shit. No, you can't. I'm like, this is like 2009.
Yeah, 2009.
So like, it's not like on streaming services or anything like that.
You're going to have to find a bootleg in LA.
That's literally what I did. I'm not kidding. I found a dude that was selling this in downtown LA.
Okay.
I went there. It was like a 10 DVD set marked with Sharpies. Incredible.
Yeah.
Awful quality. But I at least got a chance to see what we were going to do.
Which I think you guys portrayed very well. Because Ryuki's a dark show.
It is. It really is. And my favorite part of it was being able to play two different versions of my character.
Okay.
Because like, you know, at the time, you know, I was really inspired by like things like, and I kept trying to say this to the Wangs. They were like, nah. I kept dreaming, this is like Batman Begins. They're like, whoa, not that intense. And this is not as good as that. I'm like, well, yeah, it can be. So I was really into that kind of stuff, like Dark Knight, all that kind of stuff. So I was like, I really want to be the strong superhero character, Bruce Wayne type. And they're like, we want you to be happy. And I'm like, oh, okay, yeah, I'll be happy, I guess. So then being able to play Adam, like the opposite, it was fun to be able to toy with that a little bit.
Now, noticing that you're doing a lot more con experiences, interacting with fans, how's that been for you?
It's funny because the last time I was here was like 10 years ago.
Oh,
and it was for the show. We were only here for like a couple hours.
Oh.
And we got to be like, hey guys, what's up? Yeah, we're making the show. Bye. And that's literally what it was. Did Power Morphicon last year, which was a total blast. I actually got into this thing because I wasn't really doing cons or anything like that. Mm. But my friend, Brennan Mejia, who's on Power Rangers.
Oh, who's actually a friend of our show.
Which is great. He's a wonderful human being. We've known each other since, like, 2008, when we started playing Halo together. Our thing. We became friends on Xbox. So thank you, Xbox. But yeah, he got me into doing more of these cons, and it's been a blast. I had no idea that people even cared.
Oh yeah, you're a beloved series.
I had no idea. So like, I show up and I'm like, hey, why are you dressed as me? Oh my gosh, it's neat. So like, it's been surreal. It's been very cool.
Since you got all this excitement, would you ever be down to come back for a revival of the show? Because I know your series left off saying there's other worlds in the mirror.
I mean, I'm like a big fan of like the Marvel multiverse and anything that has to do with that kind of, you know, storytelling.
Yeah.
And it's been something that I've kind of talked to Steve Wang about. Like, what would that be like? And there's a couple of. I think there's a show like Kamen Rider Time something something.
Oh, Kamen Rider Geo, the newest writer.
So there's something where they like bring back the
they're
old
bringing
people.
Back people from the 2001, yeah. 2000, and then people who just recently have like 2018.
Yeah, exactly. And like, I would be completely open to that, but there's a part of me that I'm like, if they ever did bring something like this back, it'd be cool to just show up like in a cameo form while somebody else takes
from
the reins.
Coming in.
Exactly. Like, I'm like from the alternate universe, yeah. Do a little Spider-Verse kind of thing, but like with Kamen Rider. Yeah, that'd be money. That'd be so awesome.
Well, I want to thank you for this interview.
Yeah, really, absolutely, man.
And hope you enjoy the rest of your con.
Thank you very much. You too.
And hope you guys continue watching. See you guys next time.